everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. These shoulders are bigger than I thought they were going to be, so do excuse me. Today we're going to discuss some new skincare releases that I'm probably not going to buy, to be honest with you. Why? Because they look a little bit like... You know? I've been told that these are called anti-hauls. I didn't know. That's what I'm doing today, an anti-haul. And whilst I personally feel like these would be a waste of money for me, feel free to try whatever the fuck you want. If you want it, buy it. If you want to try it, buy it. If you don't like it, give it to someone else or use it on your body. Okay, so we have to start literally Fenty Skin, Trend Mood, which is actually where most of these pictures are from, just posted this. This is the new Cookies and Clean Detox Face Mask from Fenty Skin. Okay, first of all, hang on, let me get this disclaimer out of the way. Love Rihanna. I think she's not only an amazing musical artiste, but such a brilliant businesswoman. I think Fenty is one of the only celebrity skincare brands that I can personally take seriously because their products are actually good and there's just something to it and her where you know she has so much say in what's going on and what's being created. This is tacky. I hate this. I hate this so much. So first of all, e.l.f. released something like this very similar, what, a few months ago. They're obviously not copying. Production takes such a long time. This probably was in production the same time that e.l.f. one was. It just so happens that they launched second. For me, Fenty Skin has a particular sort of class to it. It successfully kind of targets that kind of pre-teen, teen to early 20s kind of age group for me, in my opinion. That's what I think their demographic is. And it does it so well. Their sunscreen, their toner, two of the best products I've ever tried within their categories. There's something about this that brings the brand down for me. This is such a... I don't know how to describe it. This is not like a Fenty product. This doesn't feel like a Fenty product. It doesn't feel authentic to the brand. It feels kind of gimmicky. It feels like a cheap product in Fenty packaging. Do you know what I mean? There's just something that doesn't make sense about this product with this brand. They say whipped clay detox face mask. Why is it detox? You can't detox through your skin. Whipped clay detox face mask. Whipped clay and charcoal deeply clean and snatches pores. Leaves skin creamy, soft and smooth, instantly improves skin texture. Clay masks do that. They have this temporary tightening effect, like look to your skin. That's usually because they've taken off all the surface oils, giving the appearance of smaller looking pores. It's gonna be fine. The bits in it make me feel a little bit sick. This looks like cottage cheese with mold in it. I feel bad saying all this because I love Fenty Skin and the people that work at the brand are amazing. And this is probably me off the PR list now, but I really... This feels, I don't know, this doesn't feel right. Do you know what I mean? This doesn't feel right. Right, pictures are here, so I'm looking on my iPad. The next product is gonna be Kim Kardashian's skincare line. This was actually only teased over on Twitter. I'm actually half interested in this, I'm not gonna lie. Am I gonna buy it? No. I'm gonna keep it brief because we have next to no information on this brand, but it's created by Coty, who also create Kylie Skin, her okay-ish skincare line. However, more recently, Coty Skin have actually hired Dr. Shimei Fan, I think her name is, as its first scientific officer. Now, she used to be at Shiseido, which I find very interesting. They do have a keen focus on sustainability, they've already told. And this year, Coty actually announced that their new fragrances are going to be made with something called carbon-captured ethanol, because they say this is going to reduce their carbon footprint. However, the word clean has already been linked to this brand. You know how I feel about that. With them saying that clean skincare is the focus of all their brands this year. I do believe Kim Kardashian, although she makes some questionable and problematic style choices, when it comes to her fragrances in particular, she has some good taste. She has very good creative direction. And I think her fragrances bottles, as I said, they just look like works of art. I will not rush out to buy this, however. I need to see what it's going to be all about first. But I believe Kim... How do I say this? I don't really know her. Obviously, I don't know her. But I feel like she's going to have more creative direction and kind of a bit more research behind what is popular in skincare, that's probably means it's going to be clean beauty, but I'm interested to see how this is going to turn out. The skincare brands they already represent at Coty don't wow me, and I feel like Kim is going to believe any of the scientific misinformation that she's told through the brand, so let's see, I guess. The next product is the first Glossier product that they're going to launch since laying off loads of people. This is the Glossier Balm Cocon. Balm Cocoon, I'm guessing. Balm Cocoon, I don't know. I don't know how to say that. Glossier, for many reasons, isn't for me. As a brand, I feel they are more of a lifestyle club, cult, than a brand who provide skincare that people can truly benefit from and actually need. Their products are for people who already have good skin, but want to look like they have an extensive routine online. In my opinion, this new launch doesn't fall under that category for me. I think it's a product that has a place within the skincare world. Well, I think it's the type of product that has a place within the skincare realm and something that many people can benefit from. Not this exact one. We don't have a lot of details on it yet, including any ingredients. Do I put trust in the healing of my skin and recovery of my skin barrier into Glossier? Not really, no. Glossier's products have never been anything new or innovative, and I'd rather go over brand who are known for their innovation and protection of the skin. And I already can tell that lid is gonna annoy the hell out of me. It's got that, right, it's like you know metal lids, they're really finicky to screw back on, they never catch properly, you can never screw them on properly. It's gonna annoy me already. It's gonna be all lopsided. For $28, it doesn't look like you get a lot for the price either. There's rumors that it's $28. Apparently they said on their, in the comments section of their Instagram, that's going to be $28. But that's typical of Glossier. Not a lot for the money you're spending. You're paying for the lifestyle. You're paying for the packaging. My opinion. The next one is the Oscar Mayer Balogan. How do you say this? Baloney Hydra Gel Sheet Mask. I don't care. I literally couldn't give a shit. I do not care. It's just a pink hydrogel mask in hand packaging. Listen, I'm all for a good gimmick. Like, I love gimmicks. A spam mask? If this was spam and it had the texture of spam and the colors printed on there, absolutely, I'd be all up for a spam mask. This is just a pink mask with some bite marks taken out of it. This is the Dr. Jart rubber, what's it like? The rubber, the pink one? The rubber shot mask? No, not shot. The rubber one. Here, this one. This is just this one in ham color. Like, it's really nothing special. Also, its most promoted standout ingredients are witch hazel and collagen. Not bad, but fine. I love a good gimmick, but this doesn't even really look like ham just because it's pink. I don't know. Not for me. I don't care. Spam. Do it. Please, please. This is the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask in Chocolate. No. This is already my least favorite brand of lip mask. They just don't work for me. Laneige products in general are really hit or miss for me. They either work or they don't. There's no in between. But the way they've styled this product, it looks like shit. It looks like my dog's diarrhea when they have a bad stomach. This is not for me. This is such a poor choice for styling of the product. It's awful. These pictures make it look like it's going to be less firm. It makes it look like it's going to be a liquidy, whippy texture. And the actual swatch of this product on this lady lips, it looks like actual melted chocolate. And that doesn't... I'm not one of those people like, oh, I can't live without chocolate. Is it chocolate o'clock? I'm not one of those people. I don't care. Why am I so angry about this? It looks like melted chocolate on the lips. It doesn't look nice. It looks sticky. It looks wet. It looks like a three-year-old's mouth when they've just eaten chocolate and you've got bits on your lips, you know? It's a very unsuccessful set of promotional images for me. However, I have seen this being swatched. They actually released a mini version of this with a, I think it was caramel? It was like a mini caramel edition. I saw on YouTube this being swatched and it looks firm. It looks like the Laneige lip mask, like the texture they usually are. And it pretty much goes on clear. But for me, I don't like chocolate, like, flavoured stuff anyway. Chocolate cake. Bars of, I like, but chocolate flavoured anything is not for me. From the styling of this product has already ruined it for me. It's not a lip mask brand I'd go for anyway. Clavu, do a much better one. Kai Skin Clarifying Serum. We're going a bit older now because I haven't done one of these videos for a long time. I'm not going to lie, this looks fine. It looks like the Ordinary's niacinamide and zinc version, but with a nicer texture, actually. It's nothing new. There's a million and one niacinamide and zinc serums out there. I don't really think every brand needs their own version of whatever the Ordinary are doing that is popular. However, if they can improve on the original, then fine. And for me, the stickiness of the Ordinary serum compared to what's available now it's kind of unacceptable that the Ordinary are just putting that out. Am I buying this? No, because I have so many serums like this with nicer textures and formulations than The Ordinary. I don't need this. Like I said, I don't need every single brand's version of what's popular. Is buying this going to cause you any harm? No, other than your wallet, because it's £30. Actually, yeah, no, fuck no, I'm not buying this. 30 quid when you can buy The Ordinary's for what, a fiver? No. And if you don't like The Ordinary's texture, the Inculus have a great niacinamide serum that's a nicer texture and still no more than a tenner, you know? And honestly, the toner looks fine too. They have a BHA toner, very minimal ingredient list, which I'm usually not bothered about. But when it comes to things like chemical exfoliants, I just kind of want it to do what it does, you know? However, for this price, for Kylie Skin, you're better off just spending your money on brands like Paula's Choice, whose BHA product is iconic for a reason. They do a huge jumbo size now for 50 quid, I think. And that will be worth every single penny, I promise you. Let's talk about the Supergoop Daily Dose Hydra-Ceramide Boost Plus SPF 40 Oil. I hate the look of this. Supergoop. Listen, number one, Supergoop. You don't need every step of your skincare routine to have SPF in it. Stop it. Stop doing this, Supergoop. You make amazing sunscreens. I get it. And I always stick up for you when people confuse you with Gwyneth Paltrow's brand. But I can't keep doing this. You just don't need sunscreen in every step of your routine. Why do we now need a sunscreen oil? Point number two, oil during the day is not for me. I'm an oily person. My T-zone gets very, very oily. Absolute, I'm not putting oil on during the day with SPF in. No way. Absolutely not. Also, another point about this is when you look at all the promotional images, what does the product look like? They all look completely different in every single picture. In one, sorry, I keep saying that, my iPad is here with the pictures on. In one, it's an oily oil. In another, it's a light serum with a creamy look to it. In another, it's a clear hydrating type looking serum. It's just, they just look so different in every single picture. They're also now subtly playing on the blue light thing. Fine, because it's interesting to have in sunscreen for sure, blue light protection, but they are using an ingredient called a blue oleoactif, which is a combination of soybean oil, polyglycerol disoterate, rice extract, rice germ extract. Ingredients we are familiar with. However, in their YouTube video and advertising, they say this.
Until the unique innovation of blue oleoactif, rice germ had never been used before in any cosmetic application.
They say that rice has like never been used in skincare. Yes, it has. It has all the time. Loads. In fact, it's in Glow Recipe's Watermelon Mist, it's in Strivectin's Full Spectrum SPF, and Hello Sunday's Primer, amongst many, many more products. It's been used a lot. That is a great ingredient still, but as far as sun protection goes, the science, for me, Supergoop as a brand, how do I say this without being rude? I'm losing more and more respect for them with every product launch, I must be honest. Like, what's their next product going to be? A toner with sunscreen in? Probably. It's just not needed. Also, if people are teaming up an oil with another sunscreen, that's usually not the best thing to do. Oils can often break down sunscreen. Of course, in this oil, it's formulated to work together. But if you're layering up sunscreens, it's probably not the best idea. I feel like they're making sun protection way more confusing than it ever has to be. Just use a good sunscreen. The Supergoop Unseen Sunscreen is incredible. Use that. That's the only product for this you need to buy. Anyway, there's my little rant in my big shoulders. Let me know if you're going to try any of these products, if you tried them, if you're going to buy them when they release. Let me know in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.